Along the length of the Texas coast, the mingling of land and water creates a mosaic of prairie and marsh. This habitat supports an amazing array of plant and animal life. Waterfowl are one of the marsh's most conspicuous inhabitants, ducks in particular. Most ducks migrate from northern breeding grounds to winter in warmer southern climates. The northern shoveler nests in Canada, but winters in Texas and as far south as Central America. The same can be said for the American widgeon. Teal species, like the green-winged teal and the blue-winged teal, travel even farther, from the Arctic Circle down to the equator. This is the mottled duck. It stays put and spends its whole life in Texas.
The mottled duck's unique in that it's non-migratory, essentially. It will travel along the coast, within the Gulf Coast, but they don't make expansive movements up into the breeding grounds that most other waterfowl will do up in the prairies.
Another difference is the mottled duck's coloring. With most ducks, the drakes are more colorful than the hens, like these pintails, or this cinnamon teal. The same is true for shovelers. This pair of mottled ducks looks almost identical, except for their bills. The drake is the one in front. His bill is greenish yellow. Since mottled ducks are so linked to their habitat, they're an excellent indicator of the health of the marsh.
If you have a healthy marsh, you have a good production of the mottled ducks. This year is a prime example. We have pretty poor habitat conditions and consequently very, very little nesting success.
A decline in the numbers of mottled ducks prompted biologists to monitor their population by banding captured birds.
You get annual survival information, you get movements from east to west and up and down the coast, and you get information on the survival of the different age classes.
We're studying the reproductive ecology of mottled ducks. The way we're doing that is by capturing female mottled ducks and implanting radio transmitters in them. But what that allows us to do is to monitor their daily movements and their activities, nest site selection and things like that. We can look at them real closely and see where they're nesting and how successful they are in their nests and then how successful they are in raising their ducklings.
Biologists catch mottled ducks in a variety of ways. One of the most dramatic is the rocket net. The team moves in quickly to remove the captured ducks. Ducks that have bands already, or they won't be fitted with transmitters, are immediately released.
We're in our sixth year of banding. Actually started out as a five-year program. We started in 97 just as a test run on it to see how the different techniques work, and this is actually the fifth year of complete banding.
Hens for the telemetry study are taken to a nearby animal clinic.
It's been a neat project, Rich, and everything. Do you think you're going to do it again next year or not?
Probably not.
You don't think so, huh?
Probably
need to get over here.
The hens are given an anesthesia, and then a veterinarian surgically implants the transmitters. Thank you. surgery doesn't last long, and the hens quickly recover.
You know, it's a traumatic procedure. There's no doubt about that, but the recovery has been quite well. And we have seen some long distance movements that indicate that it's not a great hindrance to the bird. Well, most every bird we implanted has flown off as though you wouldn't know anything had happened to her. The ones that didn't recover, I guess the way to look at it, it's the best technology we have at the moment. It's not perfect, but it seems to work.
All of this generates data, which, combined with computer analysis, gives us a glimpse into the daily life of the mottled duck.
Here, she crossed over. This is the Brazoria River. She went into a little cattail marsh here for about 4 days, looks like. And she moved over into our freshwater impoundment here on Peach Point, where it looks like she spent the remainder of her time in there until fledging. That pretty much shows where she was.
Mottled ducks and the marsh. You can't separate the two. Their fates are linked, and their future uncertain.
We found a pretty strong correlation between water conditions and nesting success and brood survival. We found that in dry conditions, the birds, they just don't make it. Habitat loss is certainly would be my biggest concern. I mean, there's a lot of things that have been going on with filling of wetlands. Also, urban expanse is certainly an issue. So there's been a lot of habitat loss and also habitat degradation to some extent.
The marsh is a natural filtering system for water, and it's very productive for invertebrate life and also fish and crabs and shrimp. Migrating waterfowl use it very extensively with shorebirds, other water-dependent birds. It's a pretty good indicator what's happening here on the Texas coast. If it's not a healthy environment for mottled ducks, then it's probably not going to be healthy for us either.